Hi everyone! So if you want to see how to create this necklace and bracelet holder at home for under $20, then keep on watching and I will show you how. Okay, so some materials that you're going to need. Hot glue gun, scissors, a ruler, some permanent glue, a Sharpie, plywood for your base, 3 paper towel rolls, and 1 toilet paper roll. You're also going to need some fabric or some felt, and you're going to need some recycled paper, newspapers, or magazines, some scotch tape, 2 plastic sheets, some spray paint or acrylic paint, and some paint brushes. Okay, to start, we're going to need to mark our paper towel roll as well as our toilet paper roll. So I'm just going to take my Sharpie and place an X right here at the edge, and directly across from it, I'm going to place another X. These X's are going to mark where we're going to need to cut later on. If you're using an 8.5 by 11 inch piece of plastic like I am here, you will not need to cut this down for the paper towel roll. However, you will need to cut it down to size for the toilet paper roll. So now you're just going to take your plastic and wrap this around your paper towel roll and make sure you do it tightly. You're going to grab a piece of tape and you're going to tape it right along the edge on both ends. And you're going to leave some running off of the edge just to make it easier to remove later on. Now take your hot glue gun and you're going to glue down the plastic right onto your paper towel roll. Do you see how the excess glue is kind of bulging out along the edge right here? No worries, just go ahead and take the tip of your hot glue gun and press that right across any of the bulging excess glue until it melts, and then you're just going to smoothen it out right along the edge. So that way when we paint over it later, you won't have any of these bumps. So once you're done and the glue has completely dried, we're going to need to cut out the slots where we marked the X's. So use another tube as a template to draw smile lines like this. So you should have 2 on a paper towel roll and 2 on a tissue paper roll. Now we're just going to go ahead and cut them out. You should be left with something that looks like this, and just make sure that they fit right on the remaining 2 tubes. Now go ahead and grab all 4 of your tubes, and you're going to grab your recycled paper or newspaper, and you're going to completely stuff all 4 tubes. And you want to stuff them really full so that way you have actual support for your bases as well as what your jewelry will be hanging on. So make sure you really pack it in there so you'll have sturdier supports in the end. Now you're going to take your plywood base, and with a ruler you're going to measure out where the center is of your base. Yours will probably have different dimensions than mine, so go ahead and measure accordingly. Go ahead and take your Sharpie and you're going to mark 2 center points. This is basically where you're going to be placing the glue and where you're going to be applying your 2 base tubes. Now, go ahead and take your first tube and put it in place, and you're going to grip it down really tightly to make sure it doesn't slip out of the place. And you're going to take your hot glue gun and just glue around the base of your tube, and this is what's going to adhere it to your piece of plywood. This part is absolutely optional, but once both of your bases are glued down, you're just going to take some caulking and a wet sponge and preferably a cup of water right by you so you can use your wet finger to smoothen it out. So you're going to take your caulking and you're going to apply a generous amount around the base, and you're just going to smooth this out with your dampened finger and use your dampened sponge to wipe off any of the excess. The reason I'm doing this step is to make the base a little bit smoother in the end when I go to paint it. So the caulking takes about an hour to dry, but you can spray paint it while it's wet. However, if you're using a paintbrush, you're going to have to wait the full hour until it's completely dry. So I've already done that, so while I wait for the paint to dry on my stand, I'm going to go ahead and show you guys how to cut out your fabric, and we're going to roll it around the two remaining tubes. For standard paper towel rolls, I went ahead and measured out two 11 by 6.5 inch rectangles and just outlined using my Sharpie. Now we're just going to go ahead and cut out our rectangles. Next, I'm going to need four circle cutouts, and I've just outlined them here, and I just used my spray paint can since it's actually just a little bit bigger than the actual tubes, but we're going to use these circles to cover the ends right here where you can see the exposed paper. So go ahead and just find anything that is a little bit larger than the actual tube, and you're just going to go ahead and outline that with your Sharpie and cut them out. Now with each circle, you're just going to apply a ring of glue, and you're going to quickly take the end of one of your tubes and just place it right on top of the glue until it's fully dried. Should look something like this. And you're going to take a pair of scissors and make some slits all the way around the edge of the fabric. And go ahead and glue down all of the edges. And once you're done with that, go ahead and continue onto the other ends until you have something that looks like this, and both tubes should be done. Now go ahead and take one of the rectangles and lay it down on the flat surface. Now it's time to roll it onto the tubes until it looks something like this. So the first thing you're going to do is, once you lay down your piece of fabric — my fabric is a stretchy kind of fabric, doesn't matter even if you're using 100% cotton, it should still stretch a little bit. So lay it down and you're going to gently tug at it, and you're going to do this lengthwise, and it's going to give you a little bit of extra length on each side, so about a quarter of an inch. So your fabric may end up curling in a little bit and be a little wavy, so make sure to smoothen that out. And you're going to place your tube about 2 inches away from the edge, and then apply your hot glue quickly along the edge and roll your tube right on top of the glue. And that should leave you with a smooth application. Now you're just going to flip it on the other side. And you're going to do the same thing, but remember to tightly roll your tubing with the fabric. So this allows for smooth fabric rather than any bumps or waves to appear. So make sure you smooth out the fabric again and tightly roll it until just a little bit of the edge is showing, and then go ahead and apply a strip of glue and roll it on top of the glue. The paper that you use to stuff the tubes comes really handy at this point. This kind of allows you to really tightly roll the tubes without deforming it and changing the shape of it. You should end up with something like this. And now you're going to have some excess fabric hanging off of both ends. You're just going to take a pair of scissors and you're going to carefully trim it. Now it's time to measure the center part of your wrapped tubing, and you're going to mark it with a Sharpie. And make sure when you go to mark your tube, you want to mark it where the seam is placed, so that way when you actually place this down onto the base tube, you won't be able to see the part that you marked. I'm using some E6000. You just want to use any permanent bond type of glue. I'm using this rather than hot glue because hot glue probably won't be able to support the jewelry that you actually place on your jewelry stand. So if you're going to be placing stuff like watches or heavier jewelry, you're going to want to make sure to use a really strong glue. I suggest E6000, but you can use whatever you have. Now go ahead and place down your tube and just use that center mark to basically guide you on where to place it. Press it down firmly so that way it adheres properly. And here is your final stand. So sure, you can buy these holders for around 20 to 30 bucks, but my bedroom decor is mostly white, and the holders from the store were only available in black. So making it yourself means you can have it in any color that you want, or any design. Plus, I had a lot of fun making this. So I hope you guys found this video helpful and you guys try it out. Thank you so much for watching and subscribing if you have, and I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye!